Wolverine is great to be a Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be
to me.
A Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be
to me.
A Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be a Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be a Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be a Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be a Michigan Wolverine is great,
it's great
to be a Michigan.
Welcome into the Michigan Football Report. Ladies and gentlemen, the number 4 Wolverines coming off a 42-7 absolute annihilation of Penn State will travel to Piscataway, New Jersey on Saturday to take on the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. Going to start off today's Michigan Football Report with a bunch of news. We'll have our Michigan Football Rumors Roundup, kind of getting the juicier side of these news stories tomorrow on Thursday. So make sure to stick with us here on Michigan Wolverines by Chat Sports on Facebook and the Chat Sports YouTube channel. First news story of the day, Quaveris Crouch, the number one running back in the country formerly, now talking about he wants to play linebacker, so they're just classifying him as an athlete. Visited this weekend for the Penn State game, spent some time with Chris Weber and former Wolverine safety Jamar Adams, who is also from North Carolina. Ironically, went to the same high school as Crouch's mother. He's going to be announcing on January 5th from NBC at the U.S. Army All-American game. Quaveris Crouch, I'm going to talk about this more in the rumors tomorrow, but he had a great visit, said the Michigan visit was his best visit to date, coming off a week when he saw Florida State and Clemson. He's been to Clemson other times. He's been to Alabama. He's been to quite a few places. Quaveris Crouch, ladies and gentlemen, I think there is a greater than 50% chance now that Michigan ends up landing him. We're going to get more into the reasons why we think that tomorrow on the Michigan Football Rumors Roundup, but keep an eye out for this one. Not saying anything is going to come in the next few days or weeks because he's not going to announce until January, but unless something drastic changes, like Michigan loses to Rutgers, I think Quaveris Crouch is trending towards being a Michigan Wolverine. And if he does, and he has a great career at Michigan, he'll have enough money in the pros to buy one of these suit jackets from Reveal. They are sponsoring the Michigan Football Report. I'm going to hold this open. Both sides. I was at the Penn State Michigan game this past weekend. Saw a lot of you there. Was rocking this coat for a little bit of it. So many people were coming up to me asking me how to buy the coat. There's still a few more days. We got them to extend it another week. Reveal Suits, info at revealsuits.com, $100 off if you email them in the next few days. There's only a couple more days to get the $100 off. Then you got to pay full price like a schmuck. Don't be a schmuck. James Yoder of the Michigan Football Report, Chat Sports sent you. Reveal Suits, info at revealsuits.com, $100 off. You will own the room in November when Michigan beats Ohio State and you've got a couple coworkers who are Buckeyes fans. Next news story here on the Michigan Football Report News Roundup. Some of these stories are a few days old, kind of catching you up midweek, making sure you didn't miss anything through the slodgy work week that you're going through. 2019 three-star Mike Sainristal, a recent decommit from Virginia Tech, committed to the Wolverines over the weekend. If you've watched this show in the past, like I know you have, you know this is no surprise at all. He has been basically a silent commit to Michigan for the past several months. Not sure why he was committed to Va Tech for so long, but a couple weeks back, decommitted from them, and he will be a member of the Michigan Wolverines 2019 class. He is a three-star. Got a lot of talent from up and down brown country up there in the Northeast. Michigan retains their standing at a top 10 class. We take a look at the 2019 24/7 composite recruiting rankings for teams. Alabama, A&M, some of the familiar faces, Oregon. Shout out to my producer, Lena Bond. I think her working at Chat Sports has certainly helped their ability to recruit athletes up there to Oregon. Get into the bottom half of the top 10, Clemson, Texas, LSU, and Michigan. With Quaveris Crouch, and with Zach Harrison, who we're going to talk about big time in tomorrow's rumor show, out there as potential Michigan commitments, I think this class is going to end up about 5 or 6 in the country with already a couple 5 stars committed today. So there's where Michigan stands in the 2019 class. Those are the up-to-the-minute 24/7 composite recruiting rankings for 2019. Let's keep it rolling with the news coming out of the weekend. Denver Warren. Funny enough, some reason in my mind, I convinced myself he's from Colorado. I guess if you say Denver Warren a few times, you just think the city of Denver. Out of Illinois, He is a four-star 2020 defensive lineman. He tweeted out that, hey, he's decommitting from Michigan, put a photo out there with his tweet that, hey, and we're gonna show the photo right here. Basically, it says that Michigan said that we don't have enough room for him in the 2019 or 2020 class. They're not gonna have any, you know, scholarships to give for that class for him to fit. And some people took it at face value and some were mad. A lot of people on Twitter and the message boards and Facebook groups, why wouldn't they have this kid? He loves Michigan. He wants to be here bad. His mom then put out this tweet just a little while later. She got a great name, Peaches. She has to qualify herself as Denver Humble Beast Warren's mom, which I guess you got to use his full name and his nickname in your name. But nevertheless, Peaches, she's his mom. Her name is Peaches. Regardless, she is his mom. She says, I love, love, love the University of Michigan. And I'm sure she wants her son to have another opportunity to come back to the Michigan football program. There's the analyst classy. Michigan's analyst classy. Denver Warren seems to be having classy. His mom's kind of classy. But let's dig a little bit deeper. We're going to go into this more tomorrow on the rumors roundup. But let me just say, there are some off-the-field issues. Some will say, his offer to be part of Michigan's football team may have went up in smoke if you follow my drift there and read between the tea leaves. He is it's not an issue of non-scholarship. It is more of an off-the-field issue. He's missed several games this year. And if you can read a little bit into that or watch the Michigan Football Report tomorrow when we go over this rumor, you will know the real reason why Denver Warren will not be a part of the Michigan 2020 class, at least as things stand now. We are launching a new Michigan Football YouTube channel, so you don't have to watch all these other NBA and Raiders and Cowboys videos. If we can get to 1,000 subscribers, we're going to put more of these shows on there. So go ahead, subscribe now. You hit that URL, chatsports.com/MichiganTV. And if you do, it'll redirect you there in the YouTube app or the YouTube.com direct URL. Subscribe now. Chatsports.com/MichiganTV redirects you right to the Michigan Football Report YouTube channel. Let's get you subscribed today. And we are also presented by BetDSI. If you want a free Michigan jersey, and if you want an opportunity to win tickets to the Ohio State game, go get started with BetDSI now and keep watching the show. Because in a few minutes, I'm going to tell you exactly how you can get started with a free jersey when you get going with BetDSI and have an opportunity to win tickets to Michigan facing Ohio State in Columbus in about 2.5 weeks or so from now. So get going with BetDSI today. Next up on Michigan football news, 2020 three-star running back Tim Baldwin has committed to the University of Michigan. He took an unofficial visit this past weekend for Penn State. He's out of Ashburn, Virginia, just outside of D.C. Number 342 in the country, top 30 running back overall. So he is a candidate to bump up to four-star. You know, if he remains at 342 as a senior, that would qualify him for four-star, at least how 24/7 is doing things now. But some people say he reminds them a lot of Caron Hagdon, a little undervalued, very tough, got a nose for just making people miss and putting his head down and hitting the hole. So Tim Baldwin, three-star 2020 player, has committed to Michigan. He's the fifth player to commit to the Wolverines for the 2020 class. Michigan is facing Rutgers. We all remember 2 years ago, the 78-0 blowout. Well, BetDSI and the sportsbooks out there think that Michigan is certainly not going to get that. They're gonna win by about half that if you take this line for serious. The line is Michigan 39.5 favorite on the road. That is absolutely absurd. Rutgers should be embarrassed that they are 40-point underdogs against a Big Ten foe at home. Over/under only 48.5, which means they think the score is probably going to be anywhere from 35-0 all the way up to maybe 45, 48, 50-0. Doesn't seem like they're putting any possibility of Rutgers scoring any points. And if we remember, Michigan has dominated this series the last 3 years, but Rutgers won the first matchup between the two schools as Big Ten opponents. That was kind of the end for Brady Hoke when Rutgers won in 2014. Since then, it's been all Michigan. Last year, 35-14, the 78-0 victory in 2016, and a 49-16 victory in 2015. Jim Harbaugh does not mess around when they come to Rutgers. He pounds them every single year. So go get started with BetDSI to bet this game. I am putting big money on Michigan to cover that 40-point spread. I think it's going to be about 55-0 Wolverines. All right. We teased this a little before. We have an opportunity. The ticket prices are absolutely absurd for Michigan-Ohio State. I've seen $700 to get in the door. $800-$900 to get any ticket that you'd want to take a photo from and put on your Instagrams and Twitter and say, I'm at the game. If you want tickets to the game, an opportunity to win tickets, and guaranteed to get a free jersey, get started with BetDSI. chatsports.com/bet. Promo code GOBLUE. You know how to do it. So many of you, hundreds of you have done it so far. Get going. Sign up and deposit as a new user. DM me. I'll ask you for some information. We'll get that jersey out to you. And if you want more ways to win, or if you want your entry to count for more, or if you already signed up at BetDSI, still want to have opportunity to win those Ohio State tickets. I'll be giving away 2 tickets in a couple weeks. DM me on Twitter, at James T. Yoder. And don't be one of these people following me or DM me and not following. I need the follow, too, although it's not required. It would be appreciated. chatsports.com/bet. Promo code GOBLUE gets you that 120% deposit bonus and a jersey and an opportunity to win tickets to the Michigan-Ohio State football game 2.5 weeks from now. Did you watch the Chat Sports College Football Playoff show on Tuesday night? If you did, and I hope you did, you saw that the Michigan Wolverines are now ranked number 4 in the CFP rankings through this week. Now, here is what this means. Alabama right now number 1, and Michigan is number 4. If all things remain as such, if this holds chalk, these 4 teams win out, I think it is almost a guarantee that Michigan will secure a spot in the college football playoff and play number 1 Alabama. The bookies, the sports books, our partner BetDSI thinks Michigan would have potentially no chance, nor would anyone. Alabama is 4 times as likely to win the national title as they are to lose, not win the national title, which is absolutely mind-blowing. 16x the odds of Clemson, who's number 2 in the list. But take a look here. Not too far behind Clemson and tied with Notre Dame at number 3 is Michigan. Plus 750 means you put down 10 bucks, you win 75. You put 100, you feeling confident in your Wolverines? You think they could shut down Tua? You think they could shut down Clemson should they face them? Put 10 bucks, put 20 bucks. You win 7.5x that with that plus 750 odds. So go get started with them at BetDSI. You saw the promo code for 120% deposit bonus there. Those are the college football playoff odds as they stand right now. And if Michigan makes the playoff, if they travel down south to one of the playoff semifinals, which would you prefer? The games of this year, the Cotton Bowl and the Orange Bowl, Dallas and Miami, Jerry World and some other stadium that's not nearly as sweet as Jerry World, where myself and some others were at Monday night for the Cowboys-Titans game. Dallas and Miami, which would you prefer if Michigan got into the college football playoff? Personally, I'm going to say Dallas for, I guess Sun Life is what they told me in my ear, the Sun Life Stadium in Miami. But I'm going Dallas. I want to know from you guys. Type below, Facebook Live, Michigan Wolverines by Chat Sports, and the Chat Sports YouTube channel. Which semifinal location would you prefer, Dallas or Miami? If you missed this, and some people didn't see this until, into this week, Monday, Tuesday, want to kind of recap what happened with Dylan McCaffrey on this play, which was not, a lot of people thought it was when he got tackled there, inside the 5-yard line when he was going for a touchdown. It was actually the next possession. He got hit, and you see kind of a bigger guy rolled on him there. Dylan McCaffrey broke his right collarbone, and he will be out minimum 6 weeks. There's a chance he can make it back for a bowl game, but you never know with a collarbone injury. It is his throwing collarbone, and as Michigan's backup quarterback, he has put up some nice numbers, but what I think he's done more than anything has instilled confidence in Michigan fans that if something happened to Shea Patterson, they would still be competitive with a backup quarterback in there, unlike, basically the last decade. And so Dylan McCaffrey, we saw his passing numbers there. His running numbers, and he had a long touchdown called back. He has looked really, really nice running. 10 carries, 101 yards, but also had a 70-yarder touchdown called back for kind of a cheap holding call and 1 touchdown. So 3 touchdowns in the year for Dylan McCaffrey, which leads us to this question. I want to know from you guys, give the like for Brandon Peters or the heart for Joe Milton. If something happened to Shea Patterson and they needed someone to be in there for an extended period of time, next week versus Rutgers, this week versus Rutgers, going on the line, Ohio State, a playoff appearance, potentially a Big Ten title game, who should be the backup quarterback while Dylan McCaffrey is out? Give the like for Brandon Peters, the heart on Facebook Live for Joe Milton. If you're watching on YouTube or my Twitter account live, go ahead and type the word, just type Peters or Milton. Want to kind of get a consensus, because I think some people are just going automatically to Joe Milton, but Brandon Peters did start 4 or 5 games in 2017, and that might come in handy over having a true freshman starting a big game, potentially a playoff game. All right, let's get into the next new piece of news. This one just boggles my mind because Michigan fans have been kind of just going after me saying it's not a big deal. Are you out of your mind? Shea Patterson and Dwayne Haskins from Ohio State, their quarterback, apparently, and they know each other. They were both 2016 recruits. They went to the Elite 11 camps and all that together. Talked on the phone on Monday for 20 plus minutes about Michigan State's defense. And I tweeted out, I'm not cool with this at all. I want Michigan State to beat Ohio State. No questions asked, nothing to beat around the bush about. And people are saying, oh, I want to beat, the players want to beat Ohio State at their best. You want to beat a 10-1 Ohio State. Why? Why would you want that? If Ohio State loses and Michigan beats Indiana and Rutgers, they're in the Big Ten title game. They can lose to Ohio State. I know you want to beat a good Ohio State team, but why risk it? There'd still be a small chance, maybe a 20% chance, 30%, that a two-loss Big Ten champ Michigan could get into the playoffs. I don't know why anyone would ever root for Ohio State to beat Michigan State. I want to know from you guys. If I see too many Ohio States, I'm going to lose my mind. Ohio State, Michigan State, they play this Saturday in East Lansing. So they're Ohio State's favored by 3.5 points. Want to know from you guys. Comment below, YouTube, Facebook Live. Who are you rooting for? If you don't say Michigan State, get your head examined because you were just asking for Ohio State to have an average year again. Really, kind of everyone's down on them. Beat Michigan, go to the college football playoff, and win a national title. And if that's what you want to leave out there, then you're crazy. That is not a good thing for Michigan under any circumstance. They don't need to be 10-1 for Michigan to win. If Michigan wins out, they're in. Barring some crazy circumstance, Ohio State does not need to be good for Michigan to make the playoff. All right, my bud, we've complimented each other on Twitter plenty of times, at least, you know, if you think that. Grant Newsom, he is no longer a football player, predicted by the face of Michigan football media, James Yoder, months ago, finally announced his retirement in the summer. Best of luck to him. He is now a coach on the Michigan football staff, a grad assistant tight ends. He is giving away tickets to the Michigan-Indiana season finale. He's put this tweet out, giving away tickets. The deadline is Friday, so don't wait around for this. For former and current military and police officers, there are instructions on his Twitter account where he kind of go over what the three requirements are. Number one, two tickets to the home finale, like I said, plus he said someone floated him $100. He can give you $100 spending money for parking and concessions and all that. Current or ex-military or police are eligible, and the deadline to enter is Friday, 8 p.m. Eastern. Just hit up Grant Newsom, Grant_Newsom on Twitter, the current graduate assistant tight end coach for the Wolverines, former Michigan offensive lineman, and you could be going to the Michigan-Indiana game with 100 bones in your pocket, courtesy of Grant Newsom. All right, that is the latest from Grant Newsom. I would like to encourage you to subscribe to the Michigan Football Report podcast. All right, I'm gonna ask Siri. I'm gonna show you how to do it right here. Siri, subscribe to the Michigan Football Report podcast. Yes. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. It is that easy. You hold your phone, you press the Siri button, you say, subscribe to Michigan Football Report podcast, maybe mention Chat Sports, maybe mention James Yoder. You say yes, you will be subscribed to the number one Michigan football podcast, at least according to my mom, out there on the internet, on the iTunes store. We're only on, you know, iTunes right now. We probably can get on Google, although I really haven't cared too much about getting on there. I don't know people who have Androids, if they listen to podcasts or not. But on iPhone, we're dominating, and it is a touch of a button. Subscribe, and we'll start sending you push notifications every time there's a new episode. You don't have to rely on just Facebook and YouTube. Go ahead and do that now. The URL there is the bottom, chatsports.com/Yoder, if you just can't figure out how to use Siri. Kurt Taylor, Michigan's sixth-string running back, a second-year man out of the state of Georgia, undersized, a hard worker, so they say, three-star recruit, as I said, 5'8", 195. He was sixth on the depth chart, is going to transfer out of Michigan. I don't understand these mid to, almost end-of-year transfers. I don't know if they're going to get this year of eligibility back. He already redshirted last year. Is he going to have to sit out 19? It's really tough to tell with these new rules, but I find it intriguing that he's transferring. Maybe he wasn't working hard. I'm not going to put speculation there, but his father tried to profit off of his his affiliation and his commitment and scholarship to the University of Michigan. Check out this line of t-shirts. Hard work is undefeated. Kurt Taylor's father, Kurt Taylor Sr., has this t-shirt line currently for sale at most of the places you can buy Michigan football gear. I find it a little bit ironic, to say the least. So Kurt Taylor Sr., hard work is undefeated. To Junior, I would say this. Start working hard, get into a scholarship somewhere else, and live up to the t-shirt glory that your father has put in front of you. But I don't expect that t-shirt to sell much more now that Kurt Taylor won't be part of the Michigan football program going forward. Want to tell you one more time, in case you missed it at the beginning of the show, about Reveal Suits. I'm going to bat for you guys. I'm saying, give me another couple weeks. People saying they want to wait until they get their Christmas shopping done. They want to ask for this for Christmas shopping. In for Reveal Suits. Check this bad boy out. It is maize and blue lined. You can roll up the sleeves. One of these weeks, I'm going to put this thing on inside out, and you can get $100 off of this coat. $100 off of the best sports coat of all time. Reveal Suits. Email them info@revealsuits.com to get that $100 locked in right now. Shea Patterson is having quite the year, ladies and gentlemen. I want to throw up these stats. Shea has now surpassed Dwayne Haskins. Apparently, his phone buddy, they were taking phone calls a couple days ago. Now they are number one and two in QBR, is a stat that's put out there. Kind of, you know, just the quarterback's efficiency in the Big Ten. Shea Patterson, number one, 81.0, 0.1% over, 0.1% of a point, I guess, over Ohio State's Dwayne Haskins, who is at 80.9. So this is the latest, the top five in QBR. You notice you don't see any Brian Lewerke there. You don't see the Penn State quarterback, Trace McSorley. You see Shea Patterson up there, number one in the Big Ten, the most efficient quarterback in QBR above Dwayne Haskins. Do you want to see Shea Patterson? Do you want to see Dwayne Haskins play in person in a couple weeks and be rocking a maize Michigan football Jordan brand jersey? Chat Sports and Bet DSI are the place to go, the place to do it. Hundreds of you have done it, and now we're giving you opportunities to get the jersey and have the opportunity to win tickets. You sign up and deposit with Chat with Bet DSI, chatsports.com/bet. That gets you 120% deposit bonus plus the jersey, no questions asked. You DM me on that, I'll get you a couple pieces of information to send you the jersey, and then follow me at James Teodor on Twitter. We're going to keep giving you more ways to win. If you've deposited and signed up with BetDSI, you've got your jersey, you can still have the opportunity to win. Just hit me up on Twitter, I'll tell you what you've got to do. The more you do, the more people you drive, etc., the more entries you're going to get, and you actually have a pretty good chance. We're not going to, you know, open this up to thousands of people. It's not going to be insurmountable odds. So go ahead and get started. chatsports.com/bet. Promo code GOBLUE. Make your first deposit with BetDSI and DM me. If you've already done it, DM me anyways. I'll tell you some other ways to get started. The Michigan defense is out of control good. We're looking at an all-time defense. I want to give you an update on where the stats are, because if it wasn't for a couple of late drives in Wisconsin and Penn State game, Michigan could be in the top two or three in all of these statistical categories, and might even be number one in scoring D, had the second string defense not giving up a late touchdown to Wisconsin and Penn State, and of course the defense, the offense fumbled inside the 10 to give up that one touchdown versus Michigan State. But nevertheless, number one in total D by an absurd margin. Take a look at this top 10 total defense in college football through today, November 7th, through last week's games. Michigan number one at 216. That is almost 50 yards better per game than number two Miami, 48 yards to be exact. And if you see from one to two, that gap there is bigger than the gap from number two Miami to number 10 San Diego State. Those teams are only separated by, what are they, like 60 or 20 some odd yards. That is insane to me. Michigan is without question the best defense in the country. They are number one in passing, number one in total defense, number three in scoring, and number eight in rushing defense at 93.9 yards per game. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy it. This is an all-time defense. This is maybe on par or better than the 97 defense, although if they could take back that first half against Notre Dame, I might be able to give them the vote of confidence over the 97 defense. But three games to go in the regular season, you cannot make a claim for the best defense in school history or Big Ten history if you lose that game to Ohio State coming up here in a few weeks. And thinking about that, think what this defense is. What would it take to beat Alabama? I think it would take the best passing defense in the country, a defensive line that goes two or three deep at every position that can sack the quarterback. Could that be the recipe to beat Tua Tagovailoa and this amazing Alabama passing and running attack? Could Michigan beat Alabama? Take your maize and blue colored glasses off. Take your Chat Sports given maize jersey off. Throw it on the ground. Be objective here. Could Alabama, Michigan beat Alabama? Type go blue if it's yes. Type N if it's no. I want to know from you guys below in the comment section here on Facebook Live and the Chat Sports YouTube channel. Also, James Yoder's Periscope/Twitter Live account. Could Michigan beat Alabama? Want to get to 1,000 subscribers, as I said just a few minutes ago, on the new YouTube channel. I want to start putting content there, but if a tree falls in the forest and nobody's listening, or nobody's there, does it actually happen? You know the old saying. So got to get to 1,000 subscribers. Chatsports.com/MichiganTV redirects you right there. Get us to 1,000 subscribers and you have access to exclusive content that no one else that's not subscribed is going to be able to easily find, although I'm sure they could figure it out. Chatsports.com/MichiganTV will go and take you right there and you'll get started, or you'll get hooked up with us on YouTube, the new Michigan Football Report YouTube channel. I will be back tomorrow with Michigan football rumors. We're going to dive a little bit deeper on that Denver Warren story. We're going to talk all kinds of Zach Harrison and tell you why I think it's very likely he ends up in the maize and blue. We will see you then.